currently I'm more focused on the JavaScript. Just telling you about the, they tell me during the high school, no, the university time, they have not learned any about the secure development in software engineering. I believe Singapore also provide you the course about the secure development, secure software development. But every time, how confident of you, to answer your boss is very, I'm very sure the application is very secure. You can't know, right? Because from my last, I can say last half year ago, I remember one day, I saw the application with the forward, the company also forward, the company nearby, I see that the password is explored inside the source code. And also the backend of the, you can right click and view the, so the script, the HTML script, the password at there. Okay, who am I? I think I no need to introduce myself again. I think most of you have seen me before. I am certified in Azure's Microsoft Azure already 3 years. Okay, if you today want to learn to hacking, sorry, I will not teach you. Okay, because a lot of people ask, the first thing, can teach me how to hack Facebook? The one you can Google it, but success rate is 101% of 100. Okay, this lab just for education purpose. Okay. Yeah. The most common talk about how about the SQL injection and SSS attack. These two is the most common. Then the other two will more cover on the infrastructure if time is permit. Okay. Every month you can, if you got Azure Pass, you can activate this one. You must have sign up for Azure trial. For example, then after activate Azure trial, then you still need to activate this one every month $15. Then you can, every time you get hacked or other illegal behavior inside your application, get attacked by other people, then you will get notified. I will show you later. Okay, today most of my slide is is screenshot for you because my Azure credit is finished. I do the demo, one demo, four demo within one day, 200 is gone. Okay, here I will show you the web app. Okay, here you can get the template because I created two virtual machines. One is for attack, and another one is for defend. Okay, here I already deployed the template for Azure security for the SQL injection. Then, every time, I think most of the developer can answer this one because the firewall, how secure of the firewall? Never, still got 1% of that to get attacked to intrude your to intrude inside your firewall. Then Microsoft cooperate with the OWASP, you all hear before, also never mind. This one, you all listen here before the CEH, Certified Ethical Hacker. Yeah, most related to that. But I'm not selling you course. Okay. The one will teach you how to attack the application and do a defense. But for me, like I really less knowledge about the cybersecurity than I just use the Microsoft Azure. Okay, I just get my application, Azure Console Cleaning that I had deployed. Then here I go for patient. Then I most common, you can try a lot of websites in Singapore by using the command with the SQL. I will share with you the hints. A lot of websites in the Singapore that can by using the SQL injection. You try then, but not be cached by the government. Okay, this is not my responsibility to rescue you from the jail, okay? Because you still need to get permission from the other company. Okay, I will not tell you this one, the OMS. OMS is the services from the Microsoft Management Suite that related to the Microsoft Office 365. Then here you can get and analyze the log for the logs about how they go through the step that to do the SQL injection about your application. Okay, here I get all the thing that SQL injection. When Microsoft Azure detect the application that can that get injected by other people, here you will get notified what time and more details. You can go through one by one. Okay, here it will tell you for the security center overview. You can see that because this one, you without knowledge about cybersecurity, prevent or detect, then they will advise you how to do it by click some of the step on it. Okay, I just on the auditing and threat detection. When I on the threat detection, they will whatever happen, then you will get alert inside your email, even the SMS, but I not give the SMS. Okay, here you can see that I get the SQL injection for my database sent by Microsoft. Okay, after that, I need to prevent, always detect and prevent. Okay. They want to go, they get attacked again, your application will be show this one. Then that means that you already success prevent them for hacking, for SQL injection. Okay, another way, this one also related to your operation, Microsoft Office 365 about the operation management suite. It is the same way to show you to get the result. To get the result whenever you have block from the SQL injection. Okay.
Sorry, question. So you would like to show what actually the security center can do with respect to threat detection?
Yes, they can and provide you the
advices.
Yes.
But by the time the damage has already been done, because it has already injected,
yes,
already taken your data out. So why not focus more on prevention?
Because
rather than detecting and just providing
information. How your developer is very confident is secure about your application?
It's not about the developer confident, it's about the data prevention.
Yeah.
Protection kind of thing. So how about like having a layer which was prevented rather than...
Okay, Azure also provide you. They can, the first thing, they got give you the protection, encryption, everything. Even you did not have any knowledge about the prevention and encryption. Then they will advise you everything for encryption and do a backup, everything. Backup the Azure database.
No, I think we
didn't
get, maybe we can do
it
offline.
Okay. Anyone know the HTML5 syntax? No, right? Okay, I will show you this one. Okay. The same. Okay, the gateway for detection. Then the firewall on for detection. And also I go for my console screening. Patient and edit the application. Do you see that I can enter the script, the SQL syntax inside my dashboard? Okay. Now, this one I will not tell you because this one more on attack. Okay, to do the analysis for the SSS attack. Okay, it just show you the same. The same about the cross-site attack. It's more or less. It most or less like a SQL injection. Then we need to prevent. Okay, here. After prevent, after you implement the prevention, then you get this. The people will get this that already denied.
How do you implement the prevention?
The prevention part, I only on the prevent, prevention from the, this one, firewall. Then the rest I pass to the Microsoft Azure to handle.
Okay, so you're saying that first it was detection, so I just get the information that there was somebody trying to do the SSS attack.
Yes.
Then you just went there and changed the firewall mode from detection to prevention.
Yes.
And since you are paying $15 per month, so AKS coming, Azure firewall.
Yes.
Okay, understand. Why don't we straight away set it to prevention? That's what I'm trying to say.
I understand what you mean, sorry.
Usually before you go to production, you'll do your penetration testing on staging environment so you can replicate. Usually you want to use Kali Linux for detecting the threats on your application layer. So
Okay, that always you need to find a lot of analytics. Okay, here they already block the SSS attack, cross-site script attack. Okay, then this one, virus attack. Okay, I create one VM without any prevention. And security implementation, Azure security implementation. Okay, this one RDP. This is simulate to the your Windows Server 2012. Yeah. If 2016, you no need to do a lot of things because every time they will ask a lot of questions when you, after you installing, go to tools, everything. And now, Microsoft also provide you the new solution in coming soon in November or end of October. Okay, I download this one, the application, I download the software that contain some illegal that can attack your virtual machine. Okay, after that, you go to the your security center, that means that you don't have any endpoint protection issue because your virtual machine already got attacked. Then they advise you, you need to implement this. Then you install the endpoint protection to your VM, the Microsoft anti-malware. But if you install inside your Windows Server 2016, it does not provide this one. You need to go download by yourself. Then after that, you only can prevent the attack of your virtual machine. Okay, actually, it will show you the virus was deleted after you download the zip file that contains the virus. Then the other other thing, they will automatically help you to delete, because a lot of people once happened in my company, because somebody installed the China software and spread out to our whole network, and our company website is now for 1 week. Then after that, we only found out the thing, the software download contain a virus, and some of our data also lost already. Okay, then this one is the system center endpoint. Anyone knows system center? Don't know. That one more on the infra side. Yeah, here it will show you, you also get it. You already download the virus. Download the virus file. Because normally a lot of people don't care. This security thing pass to the computer to handle, but sometimes you don't know that the application contains a virus. Okay, virus attack. Then you can see a log. Share EI, the file to download, the EI card. Yeah. Then you get the security detection. Even after that, you also at the same time get the email from the Microsoft. Okay, DDoS attack. That means that they use your network to spam a lot of IP and IP. Yeah. There are a lot of, suddenly got 100 people to access to your website, more than 1,000, because some of the application e-commerce website, because I previously using Azure Stress Test, one e-commerce website I only use the URL only. They only allow 2 minutes. Only 25 people. Is that logic for your e-commerce website? Impossible, right? That means that anything more than 25 to 30 people, they can't access. That means that any possible that your application will be that intruder and the DDoS attack. This one happens one in Malaysia. This is why always the most common case in DDoS. They're using the public IP address. For example, some of the people using some software to increase their number of view of YouTube. It's more like same like this. Okay, this one, the VM with DDoS. The metrics, we can select how what are the things that you can try. We can use the services provided by Microsoft, the diagnostic under DDoS attack or not. Then I select the resources. Resources, I use the VM with DDoS with DDoS protection. Okay, after that, I need to check the impound package. Then we need to drop the DDoS and forward the DDoS. Okay, this one, Microsoft also provide you the DDoS protection plan. This one, if you sign up for Azure, this one will include inside your $15 per month USD. Okay, DDoS protection plan. Okay, you just save it and create it. Yeah. Correct. Okay, after that, it will protect you from your VNet, your network. Then it is OS protection. Then you're using the standard plan. I currently only use standard plan. If you go for premium plan, you need to pay by your own. The one got somebody, you can get 24-hour support from the company, from Microsoft. Okay, the VM with DDoS. Then I repeat again, yeah. You need to do one more time after you implement the DDoS protection plan. You need to check again for your application. Okay, now you need to check your network. After you implement the DDoS protection plan. Yeah, and here it will show you anything under the DDoS DDoS attack, you will get the notice. Okay. After that, if you want, I will share the slide to the meetup. Then if you go through the step by step, after that you must delete all the resources. Because you only got $200 free per month if you sign up Azure Free Trial. If you go through these four demo, then you need to delete it at the same day. Because then tomorrow you can continue use your $200. This is how the people using the Azure for demo or demo for their boss or they use for some testing. Every time you must delete your resources, they will not continue to charging your application like SQL Server, everything. Except the virtual machine. Virtual machine you also must delete on the day after you finish to testing.
If I say today I write a program, then I upload, then the system I delete it away. And Microsoft will not charge me. Correct. Yes. Alright. <laughs> Okay. Yeah, this is a tips for demo purpose.
Because one of my friend try the change in the Azure. Then they say he delete after the whole day. Then after a whole day of testing the Azure got change, then delete. Then tomorrow continue, you stay for 200. If you does not delete, tomorrow is zero.
How this Azure DDoS attack is different from the Cloudflare that they have in the market, right?
Yes. Because Azure, I'm not sure other security provider.
Okay.
Yeah. Because I'm from my after I graduate, I remember my final year project until now, I still use Azure. If you ask me other, like AWS, I still got little knowledge for you. Then other, I don't know.
But how you configure depends on that. Are you using some kind of virtual appliances of Cloudflare, which is adding in your VNet? Or it is like you're specifying that your VNet route, whatever traffic comes to your VNet, first hit Cloudflare, then from Cloudflare goes to your VNet.
So it
depends on how you're configured.
Depends on your, how you configure
it. We experienced a lot of users attack one of our websites, so after that we are.
Correct. Because I am the person who. Last night I am a project executive. I also like to ask this one. Then, for one day, I direct not get my manager permission. I tell the client, your way to write the code is very insecure. Then they want to extend the time of information, ask us to rewrite the code. Then my manager asked me why you should tell. We almost want to close the project a bit. Then why we want to spend so much time about this one? This one pass to them, they do what? They does not follow, then don't follow. I think this one will be happen against and against. For example, this what I hear from their solution. I cannot tell you so much. The solution, the most common people will do is what? Change password. This is why the case happen against and against. Even you does not take any, just take this action, change password will not solve the problem, only solve the temporary problem.
So this Azure Security Center.
Yes.
I believe it's like a SaaS based, right? Or is it residing in my VNet?
SaaS. Yeah.
So that means I have to first open the port or open the connection in my firewall so that this Azure Security Connect Center can talk to my VNet.
Yes. Right.
Okay. Understood. So that's how like all the traffic first hits Security Center before it is hitting VNet.
Yeah. I still not try the Azure firewall yet.
Okay.
Because the one more complicated than this one. Yeah. Okay, this is my Twitter, YouTube channel and email, and I share a lot of about Azure Security Infra inside the TechConnect.io. If you got time, you go through, because that one I give you step by step. Okay, that's all for my presentation. If you got any questions, you can drop me the email or the meetup group. I will share the slide for you. Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
That's all for today. Okay.